that blows so strong, blows all fear away. Your love is like a raging fire, shot up in my bones. That joy that it brings is never ending, keeps on flowing with us. Yeah, your love, Lord, is enduring, unchanging, never failing. Through endless years it remains the same. Your love, Lord, has been led like a wind that lifts me up. Your goodness and mercy shall follow me. Your love, it's like a rain. Your love warms my heart and brings perfect peace. I'm in no need since I'm at ease. Your love makes me strong, cast all fear away. I'm in no need since I'm at ease. Your love warms my heart and brings perfect peace. I've been no need since I met you. Your love makes me strong, brings all fear away. I've been no need since I met you. Your love holds my heart and brings perfect peace. I've been no need since I met you. Like a raging fire, shadow in my heart. say your love, it's like a raging fire, shut up in my bones, yeah, that joy that it brings is never ending, keeps on flowing with it, your love, it's like a raging joy it brings, that joy that it's never ending, keeps on flowing within. Say your love, it's like a raging, shut up in my bones, that joy it brings, that joy that is never keeps on flowing, flowing within. Say your love, it's like a raging, shut up in my bones, that joy it brings, that joy that it brings is never ending, keeps on flowing within. Sold out to you, sold out to you, Jesus. All I am is yours. For sake of love, that's love. For sake of love, that's love. To follow Jesus, we sold out to you, Lord. Sold out to you, Jesus. Forsake all others and follow Jesus. Forsake all others, Lord.
Hello, 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 hello. This is Pastor Sam. Thank you for joining us on our program this morning. I believe that this program is going to be a blessing to you. Wherever you are watching us from, I want you to tell somebody that Pastor Samuel Ogade is live and ready to blast the air. If you are watching us on Facebook, please, there's a subscribe button there. You can subscribe to our page right now and also share as well. And if you are on Light FM, you can share to somebody that we are live on air. So I want to welcome you to my show this morning. Are you still there? That's the title of my show. Are you still there? And today we are going to be talking about entrepreneur. And we're talking about a young man, an upcoming photographer. And for me, I think he's the best in the city of 20. His work speaks. If you see most of his work in church, you will know that it's really good. And like I always say to you, I believe in young people, and I believe in focusing them and getting them in the path of God's calling for them. And so this morning, I have a very young man. He's going to introduce himself so I don't butcher things. As I see him, I see a testimony. I remember a few years ago when he came to church. As a young boy, I thought he was 30 years old. But as we got to know him, we discovered that he's a very young guy. And that day, he was drunk in the service. Can you imagine? Sunday morning. He was already on the Mount Carmel. And God touched his life. And from that day, it's a different story today. And today, he's doing a wonderful job. Wow, you need to see his works. Great work. And this morning, Zondi, welcome to Are You Still There program with me, Pastor Sam. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much, Pastor.
And talk to us. Introduce yourself. You are everywhere right now, so introduce yourself.
I go by the name of Zondi, and my surname is Ngobeni, and I'm a 23-year-old photographer.
Wow, 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 wow. And talk to us. How long have you been doing this photographing business?
Well, I've been in it for like 2 years, 2.5 years now. you know, but this year I've just started studying photography at School of Vega. So it's been almost 3 years now.
I can hear him, Media. I can hear Zondi. Well, it's a business, he's a very business-minded person. You can see his age. We're just trying to make sure that on the radio, we can hear him properly on the radio for those who are listening on radio. But I know on Facebook, Twitter, and all, the sound will be fine. You know, but we're recording, I think. Né? So you can rebroadcast on radio. But I'm hearing myself very clear, but I'm not hearing him at all. All right, wherever you are, welcome to the program. You can actually share us on Facebook, share us on Twitter, share us on Periscope, on Twitch. You can share us on Afric TV. You can share us on so many platforms right now. And this program is coming live to you from our studio in Light FM. This is Light FM, Christian online radio. We're almost a year now online, and we are breaking ground, going through many nations, and we get feedbacks, and we can see a lot of statistics of nations in which we cover. And you know what we do, but today I just say my money drive, because I'm also, this is my shift today. So you are going to see him. He's a presenter in Light FM, so, but he has his own business, and also he's a student as well. He just started the school this year, I believe.
Yes.
And then talk to us. When you do photographing, what are the things have you encountered as you do photographing around?
Well, there's a lot of things that I encounter while doing photography, because people just think photography is all about just taking a picture.
But that's what I think.
But there's a lot that goes in, like composition, like color. There's a lot of factors, contrast, highlights, shadows. There's a lot that goes in depth when you think about photography than just the picture. So I guess for me, it's about knowing all of those elements and forming a picture, you know, using those elements. Because at the end of the day, before you can take a picture, you have to have a concept. Mm. You have to picture it before you can take it. Because it's not just about...
Oh, repeat that again. You have to picture it before you can take it.
Take it, yes, sir. So before I take a picture, I just stand there, and the first thing I do is I invite the Holy Spirit to lead me, because sometimes when I'm shooting, the Holy Spirit tells me, okay, no, this angle, or no, go stand there, or do this. But before I take a picture, I have to picture it in my mind. It has to appear in my mind first, and then I have to conceptualize it, meaning I have to make it a reality, meaning I have to use all those factors I just mentioned, like contrast, highlights, composition, color. All of those things, I have to make sure they're perfect for the picture to be well.
Wow, wow. You see, I told you that this one is a guru when it comes to photographing. Well, it's a business. Can you just tell the viewers the name of your business again?
The name of my business is Zondi Effect.
Zondi Effect. Can you imagine that? Zondi Effect. Powerful. Look at the name, Zondi Effect.
Thank you.
All right, talk to us about the journey so far. How did it start? How does this start? How did you start this?
The journey is quite interesting, because back then, like, I came to church drunk, right? So as you can see, before I came to church, I was partying a lot. So I would go out with my friends, and there would be a camera, and then sometimes I would take pictures, but they would always want me to take pictures. So it never really made sense to me, but till I came to church and I became born again. Then I stopped drinking, so I was back to my senses now. Then I just decided, you know what, I want to serve in church, but I don't know what I want to do. So with the guidance of the leadership in church, they helped me find the identity of a camera. So there I was in church, having a camera.
You do hear that? I remember the day I told him, take this camera, stand here. And shoot from here, shoot like this. That is the lay one we know.
That's true.
But now he has taken it further. He's now in Vegas, ne?
Vegas.
That's powerful school, yes. School of photography. Yes. So go on, talk to us. How the journey so far?
So as I was in church, I was taking pictures. Like you said, you showed me that you have to stand here, and then, you know, because photography is about manipulating what I see.
Wow.
You know, so... As I just started serving week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, a month, 2 months. Then I started falling in love with photography, slowly but surely.
Mm.
And mind you, I believe if it was not for church, I wouldn't have found my purpose.
Mm.
Yes. So it's been an interesting journey because every day I do photography, I learn something. Yes, I know a lot. And I do produce quality and good pictures.
Mm.
But I believe that
very true. In life,
you learn every day. You never stop learning.
Mm.
Yes, Pastor.
Wow.
Until this day, that's why God gave me the opportunity to go and enhance my skills.
Mm-hmm.
Make them better.
Mm.
Yes, at the school.
And it's our amount of skill and understanding. Check out our YouTube page. You see, I did extensively on the need of skill. And understanding. It's okay. God can give you skill because we said skill comes from two places. From God impacting into you. And even though God impacts you, especially now, you still need to go and have a certificate for it. And then you learn it. You go to school and learn it. And I've seen your work, Zondi, and they are so beautiful. And on Facebook, what's your Facebook page again? Zondi
Effect.
Mm.
So it's Zondi, Z-O-N-D-I, Effect with a K. So it's one word, Zondi Effect.
So you can go to his Facebook page and then you see some of the works that he's doing there. And it's so good. It's really, really good. And if you want to really take pictures and you want good pictures and you really, really want good pictures, to me, it's the right person to contact because when he handles your photographing work, you are sure that this is guaranteed. I'm telling you. You can post it anywhere in any magazine. You can take it anywhere and you will not regret it. I guarantee you that. And then, what are the things you cover? You cover weddings?
I cover a lot. But basically, under my Facebook profile and my Instagram profile, I have all the information of what I offer and my packages.
Mm.
So I think it's better if they can just go on my profile and just see my work first and then see the types of services I offer. But I offer weddings, I do graduations, I do baby shoots, I do couple shoots, you know, anything that people want to, you know, if people want to solidify a moment and have it forever and have the right to do it, then I'm your guy. You can call me.
And then how's the response so far since you, of course, you know you're still a baby in the market.
Yes.
So how is the response so far?
Well, so far the response is awesome because, with chasing your dreams, it comes with God speaking through people.
Mm.
So I have a lot of times where God just comes through people and he tells me that, you know what, you're getting there. You're getting there, you're doing good. And obviously, the people react to your work when they like, when they comment, you know, those kind of things. The traffic of going into your profile, those kind of reports, they show you how good you're doing.
Yes.
And so far, the response is very, very positive. Yes, sir.
Now, you can send out the few moments you have on air on this program. You can actually send us a WhatsApp message. Maybe you need to ask him a question. Even after we are out of air. And the telephone numbers are there, the emails are there, and he will also give you his contact so that you can contact him for professional job. Now, you are in a very, 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 how will I call it, lucrative field. Photography is big. It's as big as this world. And it's old. You have good photographers, you know, all over the world, even here in South Africa. Now, talk to us. How is entering into this business to you? How do you feel entering this business? Because moreover, now you know you are in school.
Yes.
So you know other people's work.
Yes.
And how are you coping?
To be honest, I'm very excited more than scared or anything because it's, at the end of the day, it's what I love doing.
Mm.
And I believe that I am the best. And I'm working towards perfection.
Mm.
So as I'm just working through this journey, I'll get to a point where I inspire people that want to walk the journey I've walked or who are inspiring to become photographer and things. You know, because we're living in a world where people think you can't really chase a dream. You have to go and get a corporate our job to, you know.
That's it.
Life.
Yes, yes.
But I encourage people to get trained for what they want to do. If you want to chase your dreams, whether it be music, whether it be photography, whether it be fashion, if you want to chase your dreams, just enhance your skills, because
no, they don't enhance. They just want to jump and start producing.
Yes, and it's quite tricky, because sometimes you have to sit down with the gurus of your industry and ask them, how do you do this? How do you get here? You know, you have to attend workshops. You have to go to school. So those kind of things, they train you into becoming the best at the end of the day. And yes, I'm really excited, because I know in a couple of years I will inspire people, and yes. I'll move the gospel through photography.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, in case there are young people that might watch this now or later, I know many of them are in school now, what will you encourage them to do with their dreams?
First and foremost, I encourage everyone to give their lives to Jesus Christ. I know it's...
That's where I begin. And I'm happy when you hear this his story so far, that it begins from there. People don't know that. Continue.
People, like, young people think that Jesus is not alive and Jesus is not real based on what they hear. And, you know, they never really give Jesus a chance.
Mm.
You know? Like, when I came to church, at first I was like, okay, I want to change, but how am I going to change?
Mm.
Till I gave my life to Jesus Christ. And then from giving my life to Christ, I died.
Mm.
And Jesus rose. The light was put inside of me.
Mm.
It was lit. So, like the church says, it's Lightwell Family Church.
Mm.
Yes. So, from that day, I just became a different person. I started finding my purpose. I started, in everything we do in life, we need guidance from God, more especially the Holy Spirit that is with us every second of the day.
Mm.
So, for me, everything starts with Jesus, because Jesus can just tell you, He knows where everything we need is.
I like that.
Yes. Mm. He knows everything we need, everything, your customers, your clients, your next business, where you need to go for help. Jesus knows all of that. So I think the first step that the youth must take is giving their lives to Jesus Christ and serving God. With serving God, you will find your purpose. And finding your purpose, you will live a happy life.
Because God himself is purpose.
Yes, yes.
The moment you find God, you find purpose.
Yes, yes.
And the moment you find purpose, every other thing begins to align. Now, have you been able to cope with a lot of your friends?
Honestly, I lost a lot of friends, to just totally be honest. Because our interests are not the same anymore. You know, my friends, my old friends prefer like going out clubbing and stuff and stuff. And I don't prefer that. I prefer taking pictures. I prefer going to the movies. I prefer coming to church on Fridays. I prefer doing different things. So for me, it's all about just following yourself. Friends are there, yes, to support you and do this and that. But friends are just there for certain seasons. There are real friends that will be with you throughout. But to be honest, throughout my whole journey, it's only a handful of friends that are still with me.
Wow.
But to be honest, I lost all of our interests are not the same.
Mm.
And they, you know, when you follow Jesus, you begin to repel certain powers out of your life.
Mm.
Even though you don't know, but certain darkness starts leaving your life. Slowly but surely, people start falling off. You stop doing business. You stop going to certain places because of the light inside of you.
Mm.
So, yeah.
So, when you look at your life, because you're still very young, what do you say to young people that are, might be watching this, because we are in the morning, so most people have gone towards school, but they might watch this later. How can you motivate them? Because some have different kind of dreams. And they think that fulfilling those dreams is to be on the street. Is to go and hustle. You know, this young life. I need to go and hustle. I need an exposure. What does it mean to be exposed when you don't have purpose?
Like, again, I'll go back to my previous point of giving your life to Christ. Because, to be honest, it all starts there. Mm. There's no other shortcut. There's no other way. The journey is not short. It's not easy.
Mm.
It is a journey. You'll walk. You learn certain things.
Mm.
And as you go, you grow.
Yes.
Yes. So, it all starts with finding your purpose in God. Because you can hustle and hustle and hustle and hustle, but if the Holy Spirit is not hustling with you, you're not gonna
like
be a
that.
Successful hustler. You know, you can hustle with your own strength. You can hustle 100 rand, 200 rand, but with the guide of the Holy Spirit, He can easily bring you 1,000 rand right now, and another 1,000 within 5 minutes. So it's all about, for me, it's all about communication with God and being very close with God. Because we all humans, we all have mistakes. We grow. We become born again, and we change from our ways. Yes.
There's a scripture I want to read. It's in for this program. Let me see if it's Proverbs chapter Job. It says something just to re-echo what you're talking about now. Job chapter 20:29. Let my system come up with it. Verse 4. I think it's verse 4. Job. Now, if you are a young person, it's important you take this program serious because it's going to change your life. It will change your life. Let's start from verse 3. Sorry, I think it's verse 7. Go to verse 7. My stuff is slow here. I'll show you now. Because Job says something here that is very remarkable. And every time I see that, it touches my heart. It's for young people, especially for young folks. Because a lot of young people think that they can just go out there and dive into it.
Not a swimming pool.
Repeat that again. Is that a swimming pool? I think maybe that's why some of them are abused, because they don't even know the market.
Yeah.
Have you been able to navigate your way through the market?
Yes, I have been.
Because this is an act and entertainment.
Yes.
Remember, I was talking about the mountains we must reclaim as a church, and entertainment.
Yes.
And photography is part of act.
I was actually about to mention that everything, one thing I learned again in church is that everything you...
Yeah, Proverbs 29 verse 4.
...in life, you have to confront the powers first. So if you want to do fashion, if you want to do music, if you want to do anything, you have to first start at the foundation of it, which is spiritual more than physical.
Mm.
Yes. So you have to firstly
deal with the gates.
The gates.
Stay tuned to this program, because after this broadcast, I'm doing a I'm doing a teaching on the gates. I began a few days ago.
Yes.
The different kind of gate, the human gate,
yes.
The human gate, the personal gate.
Yes.
So I've been talking about that. I just digressed this week because I needed to share out the relevance of the church, but. Today we are talking about entrepreneur, because we need to encourage young people, especially as South Africans, that we cannot continue to depend on government for everything. You see,
yes.
we cannot all be looking for collar jobs. The government is thinking of how to share jobs, how to get people out of jobs. But now, some are thinking, I want a government job. And like I always say to you in church, that government cannot pay you to be rich. It's the work of your hands that will make you rich. You see, government can't pay you to begin to fight them tomorrow.
Yes.
They only pay you to sort out yourself. And at the end of the day, whatever they pay you is very minimal. It's small, it cannot do anything for you. But the work of your hands, you determine how much you want by your hard work or smart work. You see, so Job chapter 29 and verse 4. Wherever you are watching us, please share this program on YouTube. Share it on YouTube. If you have not subscribed to Pastor Sam Ogade YouTube, subscribe right now so that anytime we are live, you can be able to get us live. And if you are on any of our stream right now, please go ahead and share anytime you come across this program. So, Job 29 verse 4. It says, just I was in the days of my prime. Prime means youth. Put this in the old King James. Ne? See, can you read it, Zondi?
As I was in the days of my youth, when the secret of God was upon the tabernacle.
See, the secret. It's a secret. You can't. God cannot give you secrets outside. You must be in the family. So that's why we said purpose begins first from God.
Yes.
And as a young man,
yes.
having life, having strength, having vibrancy. The Bible actually talks about the young people. The joy of a young man is his strength. You see, so, but strength that is not channeled in the right direction, it's going to be strength wasted.
Yes.
Have you been able to channel your strength?
Yes,
because you know, you young people, you are so, energetic. You want to perform. Have you been able to channel this?
Yes, I've been able to channel my energy into the right direction. Because at the end of the day, I do everything for God. So you just need to channel. There's a lot of distraction, yes, that I won't lie, but you just need to channel your energy as a young person for the right things. For the right things. Because what you do now, what you plant now, what you sow, you shall reap.
They don't believe that.
They don't. And unfortunately, that's why a lot of young people love to dive into things.
You see.
Because they don't want to plant the seed and water it.
And
let it grow. If it dies, you plant again.
Mm-hmm.
You change the soil, you plant again. You move. You plant here. You plant. And eventually, it will grow into a small tree. Then it grows into a tree, a young tree, a big, until it is big. Until people wonder, hey, how long has this tree been here for?
They'll be asking you questions, yes.
Yes.
Wow. I know you're from Atridgeville, isn't it?
Yes. my hometown is Atridgeville, yes. That's where my father's parents are.
In Atridgeville?
Yes.
So talk to the young folks from Atridgeville.
Well, I'd love to encourage...
Can you speak your language if you can?
Black Rock, don't give up on your dreams. Sometimes toro require the sacrifice tedinchi. Sacrifices tedinchi require discipline enchi, and it require skill. So if you have a dream of anything, you have to work on those three things and sharpen your skills. That's the most important thing. Because your skill at the end of the day is the one that will bring you before kings. Yes. But to work high, go at Ridgeville, go hotly. If you have a dream, start somewhere. Like, sit down, firstly, and obutemudimu toroya how. Start by telling God your dream and telling him, how, God, I have a dream of building a dome for you. How do I start? How do I do that?
Yes.
And God will lead you. Okay, son, you have to start by selling maguinya.
Mm-hmm.
And by selling maguinya, you will learn entrepreneurial skills. You will learn how to communicate with clients. You know, everything in life is a process, is a step. And every step, you learn something. Because, Pastor, mind you, Mine, there are things that I didn't like doing. But in a couple of months or a couple of days, for that fact, I had to apply those things in my life. There was a lot of things that I don't like doing. But sometimes you have to go through it. And as you go through it, you learn things. God teaches you things. He teaches you slowly but surely. And then those things, they create a picture at the end of the day, which you have to hang up in a frame. That is the whole end product to it. Yes.
No, it's okay.
So, to me, like, it's just about that, you know? Yes, Pastor.
Come on, go ahead. Talk to them. It's your time.
So, yeah, like, just take your time. Take your time. Give yourself time. Be patient with God. Because one thing I've also learned is that patience. God is a patient God.
You can't push him as a young person.
You can't push him. If you wake up today and say, God, I want a car, he'll say, it's fine, you have a car, but you won't get it today. You have to go through a process. You have to do your learners. You have to go do your driving license. You have to go learn how to drive. Yes, you have a license, but you have to learn how to drive. And then you might not even get the car that you asked for. You see, you get a car that goes like this. You start there. It's God. But in your heart, you'll say, ish. When you see that, your dream car, you'll be like, ish, I got, but I asked for that car. But you forget that God is taking you somewhere. You might ask for a Bentley, but God gives you a Rolls Royce. You understand? So, but the journey to getting what you have asked for is not the same. There are some prayers that God answers immediately. Some prayers just take a day or two. Some prayers take months. Some prayers take years.
Even years.
Yes, yes. Some take decades and centuries.
Yes.
But at the end of the day, God answers.
Mm.
He answers.
Mm.
He answers prayers. So that's what we need to invest most of our time in.
Wow, wow, yes. Wow. Well, with me on Are You Still There program this morning, I'm talking to Zondi. Zondi is a photographer. It's doing the business. He has a business on the effect. He's a photographer. To me, in the city of Pretoria, I don't know about others, but in 20, this is the best photographer in the city of 20. You will not go wrong if you, whatever area you want him to help you to cover, you even do movies on music. That's the amazing thing. Graphic movies, action movies, music, you know, you can...
Videos,
yeah, music videos,
promo videos to documentaries, you know, anything that is not, we don't like, personally, I don't engage in anything that swears. So anything that opposes
love music.
Yes, love music.
I love you. That's nice. Not those I shoot you, I took you.
Very clean. We want clean content. And yeah, if you have any requests about documentaries, music videos, YouTube vlogs, you know, anything, just call us Zondi Effect. Yes,
go to his Facebook page, yes. Zondi Effect, and then go to his Instagram page, yes, where you see most of his work and most people he has taken photos with. And he's doing a great work, and that is why I decided to host him on this program so that we can do his profile. Zondi, yes, what is next for you?
Yeah, I'm asking God the same question. God is the driver of my ship.
So I like that. For me, young man thinking that way. You have a great future.
Thank you. Yeah, I receive.
Mm.
For me, I'm just listening to the temperature, the wind direction, the force, everything that is around me. I'm just listening to that to see where God is guiding me next. So for me, it's not about, I do plan, but God's plans come first for me.
Mm.
Because I can plan, I plan a lot of things, but sometimes it's God's plan that prevails. So I let God plan my next move. So, but I'm planning big things. Obviously, I'm asking and praying that God opens big doors for me.
They're going to open.
Amen, amen.
I see them open.
Amen, amen, amen.
It's just for you to stay focused.
Amen, amen, Pastor.
Mm.
So, yeah, I'm ready for whatever comes.
Wow, yes. Wow, wow. Then look at this. Do you truly love God?
I love Jesus Christ with all my life. The Son of God.
I like that.
Yes.
So advise young people. Some of them are stuck now with their ideas. They don't even know what to do with their business.
Okay. Well, firstly, it depends what kind of business you want to do.
Mm.
So there's the internet. The internet is the biggest platform in the world.
I'm telling you.
If people use the internet in the right way, they can get the right answers.
Mm.
For instance, if you want to do, let me stick to entertainment. For that purposes, if you want to be maybe a comedian, for example, you need to find people who are good at comedian.
Mm.
You need to follow those people on Instagram, see how they get followers, see how they do their work, see how they engage with their clients. See, you know, you need to learn before you get somewhere. You need to make research. It's like traveling. If you want to go to Devon, before you can pack your bags, you have to watch the week forecast and see, okay, is it gonna be cold, is it gonna be hot? So it's just about going forward in your mind. If you wanna do something, go to the gurus of that thing, the people that are leading the industry with that. And of course, you'll get the right person by the Holy Spirit.
Mm.
And once you get that person, email them, call them. People leave their details everywhere.
Mm.
You call them, you email them, hey, you know, sometimes, Pastor, you have to work for people for free just to get the experience.
People don't know that. They just want money from the beginning.
You can't.
They want salary from the beginning.
You start somewhere. You start somewhere, and that's where you learn. You learn when you're with them. You ask them questions. If you have questions, you ask them, how do I deal with this? How did you deal with this? How did you become this great? And from those little answers you get, you go home, and you start drawing that picture again that you put in the frame. You understand? So it's you start there, you just go to the gurus, the internet, YouTube teaches
reference
you a lot of things. Reference.
Yes.
It teaches you a lot of, there's nothing you can't search on YouTube or on Google. So yes.
Wow.
The internet wisely.
Wow. Wow. Okay. We're gonna round up the show now because we are live. I want him to speak more concerning future plans. What are your future plans, finally?
My future plans is to grow my business.
Yes.
And grow my clientele, most above all. And yes, do a couple of things for church through the funds that I'll get through those projects. And yeah, continue with God's purpose.
What are the people you want to appreciate quickly?
Firstly, I would like to appreciate you, Pastor.
Thank you.
I appreciate you a lot, because if it had not been for that first day when I was in church drunk, and if you had not noticed that, I probably would have been living the same life, you know, Pastor.
Amen, amen.
So thank you so much for that. Thank you to my parents, my mother, my father, Zondi and Sarang Gobeni, my sister, she's my pillar of strength, and I know she's watching right now. I love you so much, big sis. To my brother Rabe and Brian, and yeah, the rest of my family and my friends, everyone who's watching me, RB, Da Vinci, shout out, boy. You know, so yeah. Thank you to everybody who's supporting my brand above all. Yes, and thanks to Jesus.
Thank you so much. Now, this is Zondi Effect, a great photographer. I repeat that, I miss no words. It's one of the best photographers in the city of Pretoria or in the city of Twani. If you need any photographing work, movie work, any of those stuff, just give it out for the Zondi Effect guys. They will be there to give you a professional work. I guarantee you that. And thank you so much for coming on this show. Hope to see you again. I hope the next show we're going to be able to profile your work. He's still putting the works together. So the next one show that I have with him is to show those his work that he has done. He already have them, a lot of them. They are on the cloud, so they need to come to land. They need to come to the land. Zon is a good photographer. You will never miss it. The last prayer we had in the city of Twani, while we were praying for the National Day election, Zon the Effect was there to cover it. And it's on our Facebook page on Light FM and also Lightwood Family Church YouTube page. Those beautiful photos, any photo you see that is not beautiful, it's from me. But if you see good shots, it's from this gentleman and many other shots that he have taken. So thank you so much, Zondi. Like I said to you, Zondi is going to have his own show on this program. He's going to be one of our presenters. He'll be on Light FM, Light TV, he'll be broadcasting live on whatever God lay in his house to do. Zondi, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Pastor.
Thank you for coming on our program. Thank you so much. You can see him with his photography. This is his life. And you can see the way he's dressing. Thank you so much for listening to this program. Are you still there? We are coming back again at 12:30 for the next program. I'm going to be talking about the gates that you need to deal with. And I believe that this program has been a blessing to you. Before I sign out, remember, with men is impossible, but with God, all things are possible. Your dreams cannot die. No matter the delay, it's not a denier. The future is yet to come. Embrace it in faith. Like he said, when you are doing photography, before you take shots, you must first capture it with your heart, capture it with your spirit. And as you do that, next thing will start following. God bless you and shalom. Bye.